Happy March, guys. I'm starting off with an IKEA haul I want to show you guys. Ty and I went to IKEA today to do some returns, but also pick up a couple things for the house. So the first thing we picked out were some curtains. There are a couple curtains downstairs here that I want to change. For example, this one in the dining room, they were a little bit too thick and they had floral patterns on them. They're from the old owners. Same with the ones in our living room over here, which are the same thick fabric with the florals. And then the ones by the back door are like this floral pattern also that I don't like. I don't want floral pattern stuff. So we've got a semi-sheer one that will be for the living room one. So it's going to be sheer enough that it lets in the light but still provides some privacy. Then I also got this more transparent linen-ish one. See, as you can see, it's like more light, whereas this one was level 2, I guess. Or level 3, I don't know. This one has a little bit of like a linen look to it and a little bit more like less formal, so I'm putting this one in the back door area. And then we bought some new light fixtures for the counter right here. I got these like geometric ones and we're gonna put the bulb in here. I got two of them. I got two of them to replace the two that are right above our counter. I'm going to eventually change all the light fixtures in the house to either be like a black rim or black color to it, or fully white. I don't like the silver. I'm trying not to do too much hardware in the house. I don't think our house is like grandeur enough to have like chunky hardware on the house. So I'm trying to just keep it either like a black accent, a very like clean black accent, or all white. So we got two of those. And then the last thing we picked up, I wanted to pick up a mirror that I saw there that was like this nice oval-ish mirror, but they were all sold out. However, we're gonna test out this basket. It's a really popular basket slash coffee table. This is the one that's a little bit smaller. They have a wider one too. So the reason why I wanted this is because I wanted something that could kind of double as storage because we don't have a lot of storage space down in the living room. However, I wanted circular tables and I couldn't find a lot of circular tables with storage. A lot of the circular coffee tables did not have storage, so that's not what I wanted. And I'm ready to get rid of that old one that we have just standing there for now because it's holding stuff there for now. So I'm gonna try this one out. I feel like the color might be too white against like my off-white-ish couch, so we'll test it out. We'll see if we like it. I'm gonna put it up there and see if I like it, and if not, then we'll return it. Y'all, why do we keep having the worst? Why? So they came to deliver our dining table, and as part of that, they also are supposed to put it together. However, the guys realized when they got here that the Crate and Barrel forgot to give them the tools and screws needed to put the damn thing together. Like, are you serious right now? Like, why does this keep happening to us? Did I do something wrong? Is this karma? Did I do something bad? So our Miyoko situation is starting to get pretty frustrating for sure. If you guys watched the last vlog, you guys know that she had to go to the ER because she ended up having a UTI, and also we found out that she has bladder stones. They gave her antibiotics and she finished that and everything was like fine in the fact that she didn't have blood in her pee anymore. And then they gave her special diet food to hopefully dissolve the bladder stones. However, I have an inkling that she still has bladder stones. So they told me to book an x-ray with the vet in 3 to 4 weeks. So we booked one for next week. That will be around the 3-4 week mark. They have to do an x-ray to see if she still has bladder stones. And if she does, then it might be that she has to get surgery. And I'm kind of have an inkling that she still has bladder stones because the past few days, so after she finished her antibiotics, the days after that she seemed fine, but the past few days she keeps leaking everywhere. So she has incontinence whenever she's sleeping or falls asleep or feels really relaxed. She'll like lay on the floor, wake up, and then I'll find a puddle on the floor. Or she'll lay on the couch, wake up, and then I find a puddle on the couch. So it could be a sign of something else. However, it is a sign of UTIs and bladder stones. So I'm assuming that that's what it has to do, and hopefully it's not even worse than that. So we called the regular vet, and unfortunately, they told us that we have to get in touch
with the emergency vet because she was the one who originally diagnosed her, but it's like so hard to get a hold of her because she only works at the emergency vet at certain times, and then when she's in there, she's usually busy with like emergency things, so she can't return our calls. We've left so many messages with them, they haven't returned our calls, and the regular vet is saying if I need more antibiotics, that might be the case, but I would have to get them from the emergency vet because she was the one who did all like the diagnosis. So I don't know, if she doesn't call back, I'm gonna try calling again today. If I don't get anything from them, then I'm gonna have to just like book a appointment with the regular vet for her testing all over again, even though I already know what it is. It seems like they won't give her the drugs unless they do the testing. I don't really know. Anyways, I need to speak to them about that, because if the emergency vet isn't gonna get back to me, then like I can't just sit around and wait. In other news, I have decided that I'm going to paint the house, or at least some parts of it. I'm just sitting on my stairs right now. So when we bought this house, the paint that they have on here is called like pretty much builder's paint. So it's like the most basic paint that they put on your house. The previous owner, who were the ones that like I guess customized everything, they basically chose not to like do any actual paint. Like they just leave it as like this builder's paint that is the original paint. It's almost like a primer, and it's very chalky. It just scuffs really easily because really it's like a primer, not even really a paint. At first I thought I was gonna be okay with it. It's like a cool tone, has a hint of gray behind it. However, it just scuffs way too easily. And there's actually a few spots in the house that I need to spackle up or drywall up anyways. I think this house was vacant for a little while before we bought it because the owners had moved already. And I think that they didn't like control the temperature very well in here, because I found like one or two cracks along the drywall kind of like beam, like where it would kind of like go in, I guess. And I've talked to a bunch of people and they think that it has to do with not controlling the temperature in here. Basically the house shrunk and expanded too much, and it's creating like these little cracks. So I thought, you know, if we're gonna be spackling it up anyways, we're gonna have to repaint it, and if I'm gonna repaint it, I might as well repaint it in a better paint. However, taking on this whole house of painting, I mean, I might not do the whole house. I might not do like the walls inside the bedrooms, because like those are fine. I think it'll be mostly like the downstairs area for the most part. Definitely gonna do the front area because that's where like a lot of the scuffing is and it doesn't look good. Whether I do the dining room area, I don't know. And plus, I'm gonna end up choosing a little bit of a warmer color. I find that like this gray color just doesn't really match everything as well. And also looks honestly not good in photos. Whenever I take photos, it's like one of those colors that the camera can't pick up the color correctly. So it looks like this greenish tone, and then it makes my skin tone weird, because it's like they try to match that white as a white, but then everything else then is like off colored because it's not true white.
I've been sitting here contemplating if I should just attempt to change these lights myself. Ty's not home. He's been really busy helping at the restaurant. So there's a lot of house stuff I want to get done. And I feel like if I don't just do it myself, then they're not going to get done. So I'm wondering if I think I'm going to be able to do that. Couldn't do it myself, so called dad over to help. I was just telling my vlog earlier that I'm like, oh, maybe I'll try to do this myself.
Good luck.
Had to get dad to help. My Bubba just came back from her vet appointment and she is cleared of her bladder stones. Good job, Miyoko. You passed 15 bladder stones. Or dissolved or passed 15 bladder stones out of your system. Congrats, girl. Congrats. I love you so much. Congrats. Congrats, my babe. So we're in David's Bridal today, here with my mom and Ty. We have Ty's mom here as well. She's over there. We're looking at mother of the bride and mother of the groom dresses. What color are you into, mom? I don't even, the red's nice.
Burgundy, that's burgundy. Burgundy's nice.
Yeah.
Red's nice too.
Lots of colors, they have lots of colors here. So many. You just have to start picking and trying, I think.
I know. Wait, pick one more first.
Yeah, that's more covered up.
Yeah,
How about this gold one over here, Mom? Gold off the shoulder. Or here, red off the shoulder.
But it's too simple.
Okay.
Hey, what do you want? What? Here, chop.
Some. She picked two.
That one as well.
Oh, okay. Darker ones.
You're faster than me.
Here, I just want to show you a different color.
I'm also here to look at some accessories, so I'm pretty sure I'm gonna do a tiara. I really like the wider tiaras, like this one right here. They have a lot of different options for hair accessories and whatnot. Oh, this little what is it called, headband is really, really cute. These also might be cute for the hairstyle I'm going for. I'm doing more of like a side part. So these could be nice on the side of your hair as well. A lot of jewelry too. Oh, the more bling, the better. We have golds, silvers, even a rose gold section. That's Mom's selection here. The red one first?
This one bigger, right?
Yeah. She's gonna go with the navy first.
Oh, I like that too.
Yeah, I have to film you guys.
And I like both of the dresses, like, are shapely. I like it. I like both. Okay. Hey,
nice.
I wonder if the t-shirt part looks too looks too casual.
Yeah.
Right? Woo! Shot time?
Yes.
Yes, yes?
Yes, got okay. The shot. She's trying on another one.
Very fancy looking.
Move your hair. Okay, I go to you. I like
the
sleeve. Yeah, the sleeve. Yeah.
Wait,
Sylvia, you're in the way.
Oh, sorry.
Woo! Okay, your mom's turn.
Okay, try the other one.
Tell your mom
to
turn around.
Okay, turn around. Woo!
The same one or the same this one?
Yeah, it's similar, yeah. Mom, turn.
It's nice, it's nice.
I like the sexy leg, Mom. Show me your leg.
That's how you show your legs.
So I'm also headed on the David's Bridal website because I want to look at some of the shapewear that I'm going to need or that I want for my dress or underneath my dress. They have a lot of different options when it comes to shapewear. Like you can do bustier stuff or you can even do things that like literally go under your dress entirely just to give fullness or just for you to be more comfortable. So I'm probably gonna get something like a bustier just to give me more shape and hold around my boob area because I don't have very big boobs and I can't really fill up the cups in my dress because I'm so small chested, but I find that when I wear something underneath and then that on top, it just gives me more of a fuller look in the chest. And they have so many different options. Like there's backless ones as well. If you have a backless dress, David's Bridal really is just like a one-stop shop. So you not only get the dress and accessories, but like even the small things like your shapewear and what you're wearing under it. Look at all the different dress shapes you can get for slips under your dresses. Like they have, you know, this more A-line slash mermaid look, a full ball gown look, form fitting, another ball gown one, like so many different shapes to suit your dress. It kind of just like, you know, sucks you in the right places, makes you shapely, but then also gives you more volume to fill out your dress a little bit more. So we finally have our dining table and it is intact.
and it's here. But the next thing I have to do is to seal it, because it is like a raw marble. I want to seal it so that there's less risk of staining and it just doesn't absorb waters and stuff and like stain as easily. But if it's 8 chairs between Ty and I, we have pretty large-ish families, so lots of room. I mean, if I had space, I would definitely do like a 12 chair table, but 8 is what we can fit here. The marble is super, super nice. It's from CB2. So I'm just gonna wipe it down, and then I have the sealer that I'm going to use to seal the table. It's a beautiful Sunday. It's finally a weekend where it's fully above 0 degrees. So I took Miyoko out for a walk. Oh, my battery ran out, but I was saying I took Miyoko out for a walk, and then I'm gonna just tidy up the house a little bit. And then tonight I get to test if my table was cured properly. I did a test spot like a few days ago already, and it worked really well. So I'm hoping that's the same situation for the entire table. And I have so many packages that I need to deal with. Like, my whole front is filled with packages. And I don't want to show you guys the boxes because it has my address on it, but it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 boxes right here. It just all came in like 2 days, so I didn't have time to like slowly get through it. I have like 5 packages upstairs too. I need to get through that. Anyways, gonna tidy up, and then maybe once I tidy up, I'll be a little bit hungry. Yeah. Okay, we're gonna test out the table, the ceiling, the sealer on the table to see if it resists liquid. So previously, it would be similar to like, think of it like a sidewalk, like a light-colored sidewalk. When it rains, it turns darker. So obviously, obviously marble is a stone. So when I initially got it, I had wet hands and I touched it, and it immediately like turned it darker in the areas that it was wet. Why is this not focusing? So yeah, similar to a light sidewalk, if you like were to make a wet mark, it would turn darker. That's what happened. And the sealer should essentially prevent it from happening. Babe, are your hands wet?
No.
Oh, but make them wet and then you can touch it and then see. Oh wow, see,
it leaves a water streak.
Yeah. Oh,
but no
streaks. Mark. Yeah, yeah, no mark. But see how the water is kind of like pooling?
Yeah,
like it's what is it called, it's a
condensation,
like, yeah, getting together. So it's not like soaking into the marble, but instead it just sits on top of it. Oh, this is lit. That was legit, right?
That was legit. Good job.
Like, yeah, I bet if you poured a bit of water on here, it would just pool.
Let's do it. Maybe some coffee,
No, I don't want to get risky. Just a bit of water.
Ooh.
Oh! Oh wow, is it not focused? Yeah, it's like makes two little pools. You see that? There, it's just like two little water pools that are sitting on there. That's awesome.
How are we gonna do a durability test? We're gonna leave it there.
No, I don't do that. So a lot of my followers have started small businesses, and that's really exciting. I'm so excited for you guys. And a few of them have reached out, so you'll kind of see a couple of packages come in the next little while that are some stuff from my followers. This first one I have here is this pink sweatsuit, which is really cute. Whoa. Y'all know me, I love my sweatsuits. I love matching sweatsuits. And when my follower reached out and showed me this, I was like, this pink is perfect. It's like bright enough, but still a little bit of a muted tone to it. It is the perfect pink, and to have a full sweatsuit of it, I feel so blessed. Thank you so much. So this is by Reve, I don't know if I'm pronouncing this correctly, Reve Athletique. Guys, I ordered a bubble tea and I did the most despicable thing. I forgot to put balls tapioca in my bubble tea. And Ty is being such an MVP. He's taking some balls from it. Wait, no, don't wait. You're losing so much drink.
It's fine.
B, at least drink some of that drink. Don't lose it all. This was not my idea. Ty's gonna
wash these balls and put them in the drink. Babe, you don't have to do this. I didn't ask you to do this.
It's fine. You cry like a little girl.
Okay, that's enough. That's good. Okay, I have a meeting now. We got our Costco memberships, babe. We're officially Costco members.
Yo.
We went for the premium one. The girl upsold us. We got sold.
Well, we're testing. We're capable of premium membership.
So now we're gonna go. This is our first time shopping here on our own without my parents or someone else.
Without borrowing someone's card.
Yeah. So the bakery section is always the most tempting. What did we get already? Truffle waffles. So they're $5. Wow, this is where all my money goes. Okay, this is where all my money is gonna go.
Yep, that's where we're gonna get.
Okay, we're gonna get croissants. Are you gonna eat croissants with me? Because I can't eat like all of this one.
Sure.
Never a good idea to split up in Costco. I've lost Ty. He's gone. He's a goner. I feel like I actually didn't show you guys like my finished dining table stitch after I sealed it and everything. I end up choosing between two chairs. So I had originally bought these gray chairs for the other table that I was originally going to get. But then when that didn't work out, I bought these ones thinking that this would be better. And then I had to decide between the two. I ended up choosing these ones. Long story short, I ended up choosing these ones because I like the contrast, that it's like a darker gray black with the table. I just feel like the contrast looked better. We switched out the lights, so it's something a little bit more modern and matches the table. Yeah, I haven't switched out the curtains yet though. I need to do that, something less florally. I'm actually really happy with the look. Oh, here, I'll use my wide lens. Yeah, I'm really happy with how it came together. I'm really happy with how it looks, how it flows into the house. I might do like plant here or something like that. I haven't decided yet, but I'm loving the dining room sitch.